In this lesson, I'll show you two examples on how to solve science-based word problems using antiderivatives in calculus. I decided to put this video together because students often ask the question, when will I ever use calculus in real life? This series focuses on examples encountered by scientists in the real world and how we can use calculus to overcome these problems. Take for example question 1, where asked, suppose the rate of change of concentration of a vitamin in the bloodstream at time t is given by the following. If there is initially 1 milligram of vitamin in the bloodstream, then what is the concentration as a function of time? If you take a close look at this equation, you'll notice that it is the derivative of a function. So what we have to do is find the antiderivative and then subsequently substitute this value in the antiderivative to help us find that function. If you're confused, here's what I mean. To find the antiderivative of this function, first of all, you'll need to remember that e to the power of x, taking the antiderivative of this, gives you e to the power of x plus our arbitrary constant c. In our particular case, we have negative 0.3t. We're not dealing with x, we're dealing with t. And unlike this example, we have a coefficient being multiplied to that t. If you ever run into a situation like this, remember this. E to the power of kx, where k is a constant, the integral of that is 1 over k times e to the power of kx plus c. Now let's apply that to our equation. If we find the antiderivative, we end up with our original function, which I'll say is f at t is equal to, the reason why I wrote down f of t is because it's with respect to t. And surely you can swap this f with a c if you like. So applying this rule, we have negative 0.1, that's this part. And now we'll write down 1 over our k is negative 0.3, multiply 2 e to the power of negative 0.3 t plus c. So what you see here represents the function before the derivative was taken. Now, of course, the original equation didn't have a plus c. It had a number instead. That's just a placeholder. So to find c, we need to apply this information to our function. We're told that there is an initial 1 milligram of vitamin in the bloodstream. Initial means that the time at zero has a concentration of 1 milligram. So c at zero is equal to 1. I'll apply that to my function. Rather than c of t, I'll write down 1 is equal to negative 0.1 over negative 0.3 e to the power of negative 0.3 times 0. Negative 0.3 times 0 is equal to 0, and anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1. So this whole factor becomes a 1. These two, being both negative, make it positive, and that reduces down to 1/3. So we have 1 is equal to 1 over 3 plus our constant c. Rearranging for c, we bring that over. We have 1 minus 1/3, which is 2 over 3, and that's our constant. We can apply this to our equation. C at t is equal to 1 over 3 e to the power of negative 0.3t plus 2 over 3. What you see here in red is the concentration as a function of time. Let's move on to question 2. This time we're asked, a ball is thrown upward with a speed of 10 meters per second from a building that is 30 meters tall. Find a formula describing the height of the ball above the ground t seconds later. I want to start by illustrating what's happening here. Pretend that there is a building, that's the edge of the building, and you tend to throw a ball 10 meters per second up into the air. And eventually that ball will go downwards. So we will let up be positive, the upwards movement of that ball, and the downwards movement of that ball will be negative. The acceleration relates to the gravity. So the acceleration, as we know, is negative 9.8 meters per second squared. For the sake of simplicity, we will not be showing the units. Now, if we took the antiderivative of acceleration, we would end up with the function velocity. So velocity with respect to time is equal to the acceleration. Let's go ahead and find the antiderivative of negative 9.8. The antiderivative of a constant, in our case negative 9.8, is negative 9.8. I won't be using x, I'll be using t plus c. So I'll replace the antiderivative of negative 9.8 right into there, where I have the velocity as a function of time is equal to negative 9.8 t plus c. Now remember that the ball at time 0 is traveling 10 meters per second. So when t is equal to 0, this thing, the velocity is 10. So we can solve for c this way. 10 is equal to negative 9.8 times 0 plus c. Therefore, our arbitrary constant happens to be 10. Our velocity function is negative 9.8 t plus 10. Now that we found this important function, we can actually start to find the function for the displacement of this ball. And we'll call that function s with respect to t. And it turns out that taking the derivative of this gives you the velocity. So the derivative of this function gives you the velocity. And by taking the antiderivative of this, we end up with the displacement function s of t. Let's go ahead and find the antiderivative of that. We have s of t is equal to the antiderivative of negative 9.8 t is negative 9.8 t to the power of 2 over 2. The antiderivative of 10 is 10t. We're not going to use c this time. We'll use d because c has already been used. This reduces down to negative 4.9 t squared plus 10t plus d s of t. Remember, at time 0, the displacement is 30 meters, and that was given in the question. So s at 0 is equal to 30. Placing that into here, we have 30 is equal to negative 4.9 times 0, that's 0, plus 10 times 0 is 0, plus d. D is equal to 30. And now we can put together the function that gives us the displacement with respect to time. Negative 4.9 t squared plus 10t plus 30. And there you have it. Two examples on how to solve science-based word problems using antiderivatives in calculus.